It's Katie McGrath, and I play Lucy Westenra. She's very different than anyone I've ever played before. She's girly and she's flirty, and there's sort of an ease about her that I've never played. And then at the same time, what's really interesting about Lucy in this story is as time goes on, you begin to discover that everything that you see on the surface has no relation to what's going on underneath her. She's not your usual society girl. She's got a much darker center and a much greater secret that as the episode goes on and then the episodes you begin to see. And it's sort of fun to find out and play that. I think what they've done really cleverly in this version is they've got many different types of women. You know, you've got obviously got Lucy, who represents the more traditional Victorian type, who is probably only expected to marry well and have children. She's got a lot of money and her future is assured in that way. She knows where it is that she is going and what it is she has to do. And against that, she's a smart girl that never has a cause to use her intelligence. I always joke that while Mina is in, you know, medical school dissecting cadavers, Lucy is trying to decide whether pink shoes really go with the pink hat. So it's the only way she can use her intelligence, and it's stunted for her. And I think it makes her quite a frustrated character. And then in comparison, then you've got Mina, who is this sort of a very modern type of woman. She is independent. She's, you know, self-assured. She's confident. She's driving herself to be something. And I think what makes it great is the two of them being so close together and such good friends. You begin to see the highlights of each character. Lucy is... The important thing for Lucy is her relationship with Mina. And I think it's very clear from the outset that they have grown up together. They've known each other their whole lives. And by extension, she's known Harker her whole life. And I think they're friends, but I think Lucy is very jealous of Harker and guards Mina very closely for reasons that you discover later on. I'm wearing pink. Lots of pink. Yeah, it's brilliant. The costume designer is Annie Simons. And when we were doing all our initial costume fittings, I walked in and I was like, hi, nice to meet you. I'm just going to put this out here. I absolutely hate pink, and I'll wear anything you want me to wear except pink. And I look to the rack and it's like varying shades, about 40 of them. I'm like, right, so this is where we're going. And I have to say, I am a Lucy convert to pink. I wouldn't wear it as Katie, but I think this is absolutely fabulous. She has done such a clever job on it. She has given such a twist on everything to make it sort of recognizable for modern audiences while still keeping it period. And they have built such massive, such wonderfully detailed, such amazing sets, and all of a sudden we're like, oh no, everyone's gonna have to step up again. Because up until that point, you're just like, oh yeah, we're trundling along, it's fine. And then you saw the scope of what they've put together, and their sphere comes in that you have to live up to it. And it's actually a very scary feeling, but it's a fantastic feeling knowing that you're going to be part of something so massive and so wonderful and so epic and so, like, brilliantly detailed. And it's really great about Johnny. He's got this sort of sense of danger. You don't know what he's going to do at any point, and you can see that, and I think that's what makes him so great for Dracula, is just like Grayson, there is an unknown quality to both of them, and I think that's why they're so wonderful. For the viewers, what I want them to take away from it is I want them to take away a new view of Dracula. Not of vampires, because we all know about vampires, and Lord knows in the last while there has been a lot of different takes on it. But they're going back to the original story, and it's a different take on the first vampire. And I want them to see that, and to see that sometimes the old stories are the best. And everything that's there is wonderful and rich and dark and troubled and romantic and deep and meaningful and intelligent and sexy and dangerous and all of those things that Dracula has that I think people are going to enjoy.